Hello, everyone, and welcome to the inaugural episode of The Obession. I'm your host, Hardcorn. Let's get this shit started. Today, we're going to be playing Viewtiful Joe. This is one of my favorite games of all time. It's truly a classic in every sense of the word. This thing is fucking magical. We're going to be playing on New Game Plus, because I really don't want to start a whole new game again for this. And it takes me right back to the beginning, because I already saved made up. But now, let's take you on a real ride to the movies.
All the time, you know? I've been looking forward to this forever.
Well, I've been looking forward to this for a long time, too. We haven't been out on a date in forever.
Hey, stop that. This is the best part.
I am one. The dark side prevails. Have you seen just how flimsy your sense of justice is, Captain Blue?
Go away!
Come on!
And thus, Captain Blue was brought to his end. Goodbye, beautiful world. Nothing will ever be the same.
Oh, man. I missed the most important part.
Hey, I've seen this scene before.
You know why? Because this flick hit the screens way back when we were still little babies.
But that guy in the blue mask. I know I've seen him somewhere.
The girl is mine and shall serve as the object of my revenge.
Wow, that was unreal. What the heck?
Hey, what's going on? Let go of me! Joe, do something!
Well, what's happening? It's Six Machine!
Chills every time. Triumphantly fall out of the sky. And the adventure begins.
Hey, wait a minute. Am I inside the movie?
Correct, my young friend. I am Captain Blue. I am no longer able to fight because I have been defeated. You must take my place as the new action hero.
That voice, it really is Captain Blue! Whoa! Hey, can I get your autograph?
No, I am already gone. I beg of you to take up the torch of justice, young movie lover. Now go, the world is in danger. Your lady friend is waiting for you.
That's right, I have to save Sneed and Feed. The hottest bitch.
Cool.
we're getting the meat of it, the actual gameplay. The most fun part. Down, you can influence them. Like that guy gave a low marker, and if you duck down, they can get a high marker and go into rock on mode instantly, which is that dazed state. Small stuff like holding the mock speed button while you're pushing it, just like a little bit faster. It's like 25% faster, but it makes all the difference when you're trying to keep a combo going. Like, look at that. I'm moving at the snail's pace. And now, I'm zooming all around like a human. Bam! Done. Dead. See his gun spin, you just get him back. You don't gotta wait for him to fire anything like that. Small stuff. Makes the game play so smoothly. Trick where you use the same animation to play on both sides and spin fast enough. That's really good before you get the zoom power and get the zoom kick. I don't really like using a lot because it has a long startup and start and end time. So you're usually just better off doing that trick. Check it out. See? It's an instant rock on. And yeah, that's done. Pick up potions for a nice sippy. Yeah. first level.
Move on!
Always such a whimsical experience. Now we start getting the puzzles of the game. Nothing really to write home about. It's square block, square peg, square holes type of stuff. It's like slow the water down and make it big drop. Nothing to it. Every so often they have these interludes. Most of the time, you're really not. Because the only thing that's going to save, the only thing that's going to get you out of that situation is your abilities and your skill. Every so often they have little special things, like this. This is the Harrier. A mid-game boss that can appear on the first level. He's got a shitload of health, and always is generally a pretty boring fight. That's all it does is just stay in the air. I'll do that. But it shoots bullets back at you so you can kick it back at it. Just whip its ass. Easy peasy. Well, it's easy if you know what's up. As always. Some may wonder, why I should collect all the items on screen? It takes two. You need all of them after a certain point. Level enemies freeze in place so you can just wall up on them. It also amplifies your damage in slow motion. And in So now we head to the first boss. Charles III. This is in a Victorian style castle. It has a whole bunch of Japanese stuff in there.
Shows you what you know, fat brain. In movies, there has to be a plot twist. That means things always go wrong once before you get to the happy ending. Hello? Now come on, let's get this over with.
What nonsense he speaks. Come like all the ritual of sacrifice with the demon you're pathetic in the world will... Say poopsie! Almost let the cat out of the bed there! In any case, this has nothing to do with the riff-raff, right? The only thing left for you to do is... banish!
Alright! Let's get it on!
Just go for it!
I'm not gonna totally bury it. I always want you guys to see how this fight goes.
Wanders into the world of the moon and gallantly fights evil to rescue Sylvia. With the help of his superior strength, he is able to reign triumphant over the dastardly bad man, Charles III. Where could Sylvia be? Is she safe? Is she even alive? Intolerable anxiety tears at Joe's heart. What did they do to her?
What would be a good hero? I never thought this would be so hard.
Searching for Sylvia, Joe tries to track clues as to her whereabouts. Little did he know that the clues would only lead him to more problems. The next episode is Some Like It Red Hot.
That's
See
it.
You then.
Yeah. Now we go to my favorite chapter of the whole game.
Get it on!
Some Like It Red Hot. It looks beautiful, and everything about it is just so much fun. Even in the sewer, it's fun. Not a lot of games can say that. But hey, this game manages to make it tolerable. Very slow and only does a fixed amount of damage. It takes a lot of the effects. It's almost a punishment if you actually get it off. But it's useful in like two locations. And that's why most of the time I end up getting it.
Just go for it!
always hate doing that puzzle because I can't do it quickly. I can't mock speed it.
Just go for it!
It's just such a nuisance. And it comes back later in the form of a stone. And I just can't get the timing for it, no matter how many times I play it. I know I have to sit down a little bit, just keep reloading stages so I can get it right. But I don't really want to mess with that. It's one of the few things that happens by enjoyment, along with the others. Slow does a lot of stuff. It's really, really versatile. Because most of the time it's just, when you see it, it's slow down. Yeah, slow down. That's how you do it. They want you to use zoom here, but you can see it pretty easily. I never got the... It feels like a waste. There's also a bug with this bus, in that even if you get to the maximum level of boost, it will still to get across here. And also a very commonly missed item here right there. Some, I actually forget what they're called. They're like shell cans. There's a lot of hidden items around here if you're good or... Yeah, when you get it, you'll know where they're at.
Just go for it!
You'll find them on accident most of the time. No longer the sweet life for Joe. About that, if you complete the mission before they come, you can't do that. You can't turn on that button. So it makes it pretty much impossible to get over there if you're using Joe. There's a small nuance right there. Fast forwarding makes the elevator go faster instead of
just go for it!
fast forward than you can. Which is cut down a whole bunch of things to see what sticks. That's a good way of thinking about things too. Thinking outside the box. They have a pretty high three-point requirement for that area, for that mission you're doing. Thank you. I always love getting a fat shit going like that, and then it's just start yelling. This game is just so good. Like a superhero. Good superhero. You don't have to do that to finish it off. I just like doing that because it's really stylish. Doing the uppercut is slightly faster than doing another punch. So if you see the letter right there, or item in front. But your next punch will make you miss the reel. You can just cancel it into a uppercut. Or jump. Or punch again. See, that was the thing I messed up on right there. Is that I hit her with a slow zoom punch that knocked her back. And then the second punch missed. That's why I hit her with two normal punches. And then hit her with a one zoom punch.
Move on!
So she doesn't fly away and stays there, so you can keep wailing on her. But you can't win them all. This door has weird properties right here, and that any bomb it touches, it doesn't need to be on a timer. You just wait for it to slow down and blow up. It just, as soon as it makes contact, it explodes. You have to slow it down, of course, but
yo, man, what's up? What can I do for you, kiddo? I guess you heard I rule the roost around here. Am I right? Huh?
Oh, man, don't flatter yourself. You're just another one of those old attractions in this movie land.
What? Wait a minute, Jack. You mean to tell me you knew this world was called Movie Land? How interesting. Alright, spit it out. Where you from?
Huh?
Now I'm surprised I know a punk like you from the real world knew about our plans, man. It ain't gonna matter anyway after I'm finished with you, you understand? So what's with the feed watch on your arm, man? What, you think you're some kind of mega man or something?
Pretty cool, huh? I'm here to avenge Captain Blue. Just call me... I haven't come up with a good name yet.
You know who I am? I'm the one who put that star on Captain Blue's face. Now you'll be lucky if you get away with your life, boy!
Joe overcame the frightful power of Hulk Davidson. But on the blueprint that had fallen into his hands was outlined the most terrible of plans. The Shadow, seeking to stretch their evil power to the ocean itself, had planted a bomb in the underwater city of Mu. Already, water was starting to flood the city,
Thousands of lives were at risk. Joe had no choice but to abandon the search for Sylvia and race to rescue the innocence of Moo.
Dang, this is horrible. I can't even read this junk. But more importantly, a superhero needs a super ride.
Joe boards his trusty Six Machine and embarks on a mission to save the underwater city. Don't forget to see the next installment, 2 Million Leagues Under the Sea. Till then, ta-ta!
Ready, Six Machine? Let's ride!
Like everything they do, and this is just an homage to classic film. It's wonderful. And now one of my really least favorite levels in the game. Well, series of levels, that is.
Let's rock, baby! Yeah!
Just go for it!
Now I get to play Space Barrier, or Darius, or Gradius, or whatever you want to call it. Experience cool underwater physics.
Thank you.
kid dropped the game for about 8 months because I couldn't figure out this puzzle. Just simply slowing it down. You don't fast forward or anything. You gotta walk it. You gotta walk it. That's right. But you gotta go all the way over there. Hit the button. It's as simple as that. There's a brain with me to figure that out.
Yeah.
personally, that's what I do, but I can't get a combo going. Up the jump, all it does is just take it to the level. But you don't get that secret life. Secret life of pets. One of my favorite bosses in the game.
Be thinking you can just hop on the long submarine and go straight to our hideout.
Wait. That sub goes to your hideout?
No, gosh. Never mind, okay? But yeah, you have to know, mate. We need that girl for our destiny plan to escape Movie Land. What? And rule the you know, universe, I think.
What are you yapping about? Escape Movie Land.
So I just start the hashtag Escape Movie Land.
You best shut up, mate. Otherwise, I'll chew your hindquarters like a big stick of
gum. G-U-M. Gum. Gosh, do I have to spell it out on a chalkboard for you?
Yeah, so?
Just go for it!
Give me the Vegemite sandwich, maybe I'll understand.
The lives of the underwater residents have been saved.
All the points.
Suddenly,
really
the submarine
to
begins to move forward.
So
without a moment to spare, Joe leaps
to
onto
fight.
The submarine.
Fight.
Hey, wait up! Oh, come on! I want to go too!
Will this trail eventually lead to Sylvia? Will the ship become the next Noah's Ark for Joe? Or will he become the next bait for Moby Dick? To find out, don't miss the next installment of Viewtiful Joe. The Beautiful Escape.
forget what movie that's parodying. I think it's just Great Escape or something, or The Great Escape.
Let's get it on!
I've never seen it. It takes place somewhere else, probably on a submarine. Experience with both of us. That's how they wanted you to do it. So now... Now I have to go turn off the missiles. We can get through it without being hit. Yes, previously, now we have guards. satisfying him to stop. It stops dead. Through sheer force of will. Bang! It's just so slow. It's the first damn time I've gotten in the hallway in forever. Because it takes forever. I don't know, prepare to memorize, you know, some buttons. But hey, honestly, I can figure out how to put a... another video showing the other route to take through here, where it takes about 2 minutes. That one I much prefer doing, because this is so random. Like, this is the sort of thing you do once you're on novelty, and then you try to find a better solution. I got it. you also don't get a lot of VFX out of it, so it's quite saddening.
Settle this. We don't need two heroes wearing red anyway. Whoever wins has to change into a yellow outfit.
Okay. The Red Ranger.
Just go for it.
Play Red Highlander. He's programmed to do that. But if you stay on top of him and just keep wailing on him like that, you'll eventually just whittle him down to nothing. But as you saw earlier, you can only hit him 5 times so he can't start racking up huge amounts of damage.
Condition red. Condition red. All crew evacuate immediately. Condition red.
Escape of death from a sinking submarine has taught Joe a valuable lesson. But there are many more difficult trials that will present themselves to Joe. What hardships will he face, and does he have the strength to overcome? Will he find the hideout in time before the dark rituals take place? And who was the mysterious devil-like individual who appeared, then disappeared like lightning? Find out in the next episode, The Midnight Thunder Boy!
And now we get to go to another one of my favorite levels in the game, Midnight Thunder Boy. This mission's a goddamn treat and a half.
Time to go to work, guys.
Start off strong with that. It's beautiful.
Come on.
see the second level of the game, or the second chapter of the game at night. Smart solution to this is to use those drops to make the cooldown a lot more than some drops. But I prefer a different approach. Go get higher olives. Either take a shortcut like I did and use mock speed to get yourself out of there. And that's another thing. You can cancel your punches with jumping or another punch. So you can use it sometimes. If you're stuck in a red hot kick, you can break out.
Just go for it!
Yeah. one of my favorite levels in the whole game. It's just so much fun.
Emergency, emergency. This train is totally out of control. Activate emergency brakes. Repeat, activate emergency brakes.
Just go for it!
Music's pumping. You got 400 seconds to get the train. This level is incredible for writing the combos. Points. Well, not just like 12,000. It's an astronaut. Coolest boss in the game. I'll just say it now. This guy. The tits.
Friendly neighborhood arch rival, but you're a little late. The ritual has begun.
I know you.
The name's Alistair. Nice punch back there, by the way.
What's this about a ritual? I hope you guys aren't up to anything weird. Kids are watching this too, you know.
Right. Well, since you'll die anyway, I guess I can reveal to you our evil plan. Ahem. For many years, we have fought against Captain Blue for control of the world of Movieland. However, it has recently been brought to our attention that this world may in fact be fictional. If celluloid should become obsolete, we too will be destined to lie forever on the cutting room floor of history. In order to counter this threat, we have made a bold plan to break through the silver screen and take over the world beyond Hollywood.
Vision. I hate it when they have all these subplots.
The key to our success lies in the DNA of the Creator. As long as we have that DNA in our possession, we'll be able to come and go at will in the world of humans, which is why we need the girl.
The girl? You mean Sylvia?
Well, that seems to be the general idea. But hey, I don't give a rip about all that. The only thing I'm interested in is testing my own strength. You've been making waves in our world, but you should realize you're just a sidekick. Let's see who's the strongest once and for all.
Just go for it!
That works.
I'm Joe. Viewtiful Joe.
Viewtiful Joe. How fitting.
The warrior Alistair was dead. Joe felt that he had lost an old friend, and his heart was heavy with conflicting emotions. But Joe is unstoppable. He bravely hurls himself into the mystery of the Creator's DNA in order to save the lovely Sylvia. Thus, he faces the most agonizing battle any superhero could ever be forced to encounter.
Yikes! I completely forgot about Sylvia!
The grueling attacks of the evil forces know no end. Appearing before his battered body, the most imposing of the shadows shows no mercy. Don't forget to catch Joe and company next time in The Magnificent Five.
Is this it? Am I done for? You're kidding, right? Oh, come on! No! Come on! Help a brother out, huh?
Alistair.
Let's get it on!
Thanks for getting meta for us. Now we have a not fun chapter again. Fighting all the bosses. Again.
Alright, let's go kick some.
Oh, something doesn't feel right.
Like all Capcom games, well, at least most of them, they have a boss to be fighting in some way. Sometimes it feels a little, feels like they ran out of content sometimes, so you gotta do this. Easy mode way to do it. You get him caught in a loop. A big chungus over here.
You can do this.
Well, he looks
positioned
right. just gotta exploit it every so often. It makes the experience more pleasurable, so you get to the good stuff. It's like, yeah, they're fun. They're fun when they talk. You have a cutscene. But they don't have that. Now I need to head to the shop for the first time in a while. Okay, now I need to head to the shop for the first time in a while.
Move on!
There. It's like nothing happened at all.
Joe!
Hey, Sylvia. I was looking for you. What are you doing there, anyway?
Yeah, right. I've been watching you all along from here. You were so busy showing off, you hardly even thought about me.
Hey, that's not true.
So you're the one who's been knocking down shadow members like dominoes.
The final battle. Okay, this is where I defeat you and get to go home with Sylvia as my reward, right? Right? You may as well give up, because I am going to foil all of your grand plans.
My hero.
Not bad, huh?
What a character, I see. How about we strike a bargain? You join our forces as the newest member of Shadow HQ. And once we've conquered the world, you can rule over half of it. Oh, and I'll throw in the girl as well.
Even if you offered me the whole world, the real world doesn't need a sweaty flame blower like you. The world's hot enough with me in it.
Well, that's a pity. We just met and already it's time for you to say goodbye. When I'm done with you, there won't even be ashes left.
Ooh, are you saying you're too hot to handle? Yeah, try me.
Just go for it!
Joe has finally succeeded in foiling the evil Shadow's plot. Peace will return to Movie Land. But a question still remains in Joe's mind. How were the evil ones permitted to get as far as they did? What was their motivation? And how would he know that it would not happen again?
From the beginning part.
No matter what, I shall rule the real world. I will show how weak and inconsequential you are.
No! No!
Sylvia! Come on, Six Machine!
Thankfully, that's over.
Let's get it on!
Way to give it away in the title. And now space. If you wanted to farm points and all that, you gotta do it a couple of
Thank you.
After a certain point, you really don't need lives, unless you're trying to attempt something.
Move on!
And now the last real battle stage of the game.
Thank you.
You're unaffected by almost everything. In terms of like fire or lasers. So it's really trying to blow up something. There's a lot of hazards like that. Very nice something out there after you get something or right there on all fire. Versions of the boss we just had previously. It's still fun. Every enemy is a different challenge. Keeps you on your toes. At least on higher difficulties. Kids, look at that. You just saw me bowl right through them. That's if you know what you're doing.
Joe!
Gosh, it's you! How? Why?
Rise again, little one. I am Blue, the creator of this land, the lord of this world. Oh, how trivial, how inconsequential do heroes look from where I stand.
Hey, what is this? Captain Blue, enemy of evil, guardian of the world, the guy who gave us the courage to... Why, Captain Blue?
Guardian of the world? What does that mean? No matter how many villains I knock down, this world will not last.
No, I'm going out to the real world where my powers will mean something. I'll rule the entire Earth. And then I can exact revenge on you people who confined us to this fleeting, transient world of movies. Humans who just create things and then throw them away when they're bored and done with them. Just like so much tissue paper.
What are you going to do to Sylvia?
Foolish boy, you still don't get it, do you? I am the creator. I made this film and everything in it. Sylvia, I am your father, Sylvia.
That's not true. Mama told me my daddy died.
Sylvia, deep down you should know the truth by now. The same blood courses through our veins. In a way, it is true that your father has died. In his place stands the master of the world, the all-powerful controller of light and dark, me, King Blue!
King Blue, you used to be cool. Now, you're nothing but a loser. I'm gonna show you what it means to be a true hero.
Go ahead. I will snap your foolish little ideals in half.
Come on, Six Machine!
Go for it!
Go, go.
untouchable. And that's Viewtiful Joe. I hope you could see it the same way I saw it. But hey, the only way to do that is to play it yourself.
Thank you for stopping me. 20 years ago, I was hailed as the most revolutionary movie maker of my time. But it was just a fad, and I was soon forgotten. All I ever wanted to do was to create heroes. True heroes the world needed. And as if to answer my prayers, I was sucked into one of my films. And I was given the opportunity to live the life of a hero. I lost touch with reality. I forgot about my wife and daughter. I was too busy living out my fantasies. But little by little, the seed of evil had begun to sprout in my heart. Desire for revenge against the people who had betrayed me flared up, and...
Daddy?
Forgive me, Sylvia. I was wrong.
Daddy, don't be silly. You could have abandoned your ideals and ended up disillusioned and hollow like an empty shell. At least you followed your dream. I thought it was a great movie. Just think of all the fans waiting for your next production. You can't disappoint them.
Oh, Sylvia.
Look, Blue. Everybody loves a happy ending. Wait a minute. Wasn't I supposed to be the main character here?
Yes. But there's more to this story.
Warning, warning. Large numbers of UFO troops detected closing into Earth. Motivation, world domination. Missile fired. 60 seconds to impact.
Already sequel, baby.
Uh-oh. That doesn't sound good. What did you do, Captain?
It doesn't.
Like I said, there's more to this story. There's two more times when Earth will be in danger. And each time, a hero must stand up to defend it.
Wow. What did you say? Did you say two more times?
That's right. But I'm the director, so trust me on this one, will you? Although I admit, there was a slight change in the plot. But it doesn't matter now. The world has a new young hero called Viewtiful Joe to protect them. Show them again how a hero is supposed to be.
I guess you're right. Well, then I guess I should be going now.
Wait for me. Daddy, I'm going too.
What?
Are you out of your mind?
Look at it this way. Ever since coming to this world, I haven't done anything. Come on, there might be a hero in me too, you know. So, Daddy, can I have a V-Watch? Please? You can do this, right? You're the big director.
Well,
Looks like the party's about to begin any minute now. But you know, in the movies...
There always has to be a plot twist. That means that things always go wrong once before you get to the happy ending. Isn't that right, Joe?
That's right, my girl. This is where the story really starts getting interesting. Come on, partner. Leave this to...
Viewtiful Joe and Sylvia!
That was an adventure. I'm glad I got to share this all with you. I usually go around and play this game on and off. Once or a couple times every year. not a lot of games. There's not enough games that do that. Or have an enemy viewer or some sort. And I would like to know the name of your enemy. But I don't have the manual. Or you don't make a manual. And then I gotta buy a guide or read about it. And find out, like, Cromartie Surfer. Or Harrier. I'm not gonna know that. I'm not gonna know that on first playthrough. Beautiful. Thanks for coming. Hope to see you next time.
To Smash!